What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Exotic Astrology again. Nice to see you after so long. Finally, I've started making videos again. Alright, and today's topic is very important, very crucial for our spiritual progress. Because if you do not understand this, then at some point, somewhere down the line in our life, we might feel that we are stuck, we are not progressing. But if we understand this, then our spiritual journey will be like a royal road, as they say, na? Cakewalk. Alright, so today's video is on what does it mean to have faith in God. Alright, so that's the meaning of that's the topic of today. And as usual, if you're new to the channel and you have not yet subscribed, then please subscribe to it. And today is also Narsingh Chaturdashi, 28th year in Germany. So I would like to wish every one of you a very happy Narsingh Chaturdashi festival. And I have already made the video on Narsingh Chaturdashi. Please see the link in the description, in the place below. And if you want a consultation, then please approach me through my website. That link is also there in the description. And I also have a video on the Narsimh Aarti, which I had made months back. So that link is also there in the description below. All right. And before I begin, as I always say, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him. Because today, even Hiranyakashyap found God. Narsingh Dev broke apart the pillar and he appeared and he ripped apart the chest of Hiranyakashyapu. His stomach, chest, kidney, intestines, everything was out. Alright. So there you go. So today's video is on what is the meaning of the statement that I have faith in God. Generally, we'll hear people saying, oh, I have faith in God. I'm a believer. Yes, I'm not an atheist. I love God. I want God. I know God is there. Yes. So what does it mean? Because many a times it can happen that we do not understand what is the meaning of the word faith. We may have the understanding, but it can happen that we have a very narrow, shallow, incomplete understanding. So basically, in today's society, what is the definition of faith in God? Faith in God simply means, oh, you believe that there is a imaginary entity called God. Nah? He will give you whatever you want. Yes, that's the definition. So as this example is given, that sometimes when God fulfills your desires, then you become a follower. Yes, you become a devotee of God. And then when God does not fulfill your ambitions, your desires, your hopes, wishes, dreams, goals, aspirations, then you become an atheist. Yes, that always happens with people. I keep seeing people, now they tell me, in my friends, in my society, in my relatives and so many other places, I keep seeing that, oh, I'm very thankful to God. Why? Oh, because I wanted this, he gave that. Yes. So I have seen people, couples in India who have had love marriages. They tell me, oh, I went to Tirupati temple and my parents were not agreeing for us to marry because I was from a Brahmin family. My girlfriend was from a different family. Yes. So they were not agreeing. Then I went to Tirupati and I gave some donation and then God sanctioned it. Yes. So God is great. He exists. I have full faith in God. Yes. But the question is that a right way or is that the right approach of faith? The answer is no, because today God has fulfilled your desire, but tomorrow he may not fulfill. Or tomorrow he may do the worse. He may take it away from you. Because Lord Krishna says in the scriptures, this is there in the Mahabharata, Yasyaham anugrenami harishye taddhanam sanayak. Lord Krishna says to Yudhishthira Maharaj that when I offer my special blessings to somebody, should I repeat, when I give my special blessings to somebody, I send them to the heavens, right? No, when I offer my special blessings to somebody, I take away everything which they have. I will take away your girlfriend, your boyfriend, your husband, your wife, your children, your mother, your father, everything. Everybody, whatever you have, I will strip you. You will be totally helpless. So, the best definition of faith is not that, oh, I am having faith because God has fulfilled my desire. Because then God may not fulfill. So one of my gurus used to say, the best part about God is that he never listens to us. Should I repeat? The best part about God is he never listens to us. He only listens to one person. Who is that? Himself. So God only listens to himself. He doesn't listen to anybody. Okay. Which means, if he, and this is for a sadhaka who is trying to go close towards God in his spiritual progress, alright? For other materialistic, mundane people, whatever is there in the karma, that is given to them. But for a person who is a sadhak, which means he or she is trying to go close to God, then God, Lord Krishna, takes him away from the captivity of the nine planets, which are understood through astrology. And Lord Krishna personally arranges his or her life in a way that he or she can make the ultimate spiritual advancement. Which means that we should not make our material success as a barometer for our spiritual advancement. Should I repeat? We should not make our material success as a barometer of our connection to God. Which means we should not think that only if we have money, dhanam janam sundarim, dhanam, which means we have wealth, money, prosperity, janam, we have a birth in a very high family, yes, sundarim means good looking members of the opposite sex running behind us, or maybe we are running behind them, either ways. So suppose we have a very beautiful girlfriend, or we have a very handsome boyfriend, yes, so we should not think that only then God is blessing us, yes, which means our connection to God should not be based on the mundane achievements which we have, yes, because in the Mahabharata, time and example, again we see the examples of Pandavas, they are perfect examples of this. You cannot find anybody better than this, yes. You see the life of Yudhishthir Maharaj, you see the life of Bhim, Arjun, Nakul, Sahadev, you see the life of Draupadi, yes. Can you imagine the casualties which they had? Imagine the losses. They lost Abhimanyu. Draupadi lost her father. Drupad was killed. Dhrishtadyumna, her brother, was killed. All of her five sons were massacred brutally in the dead of the night by Ashwatthama. And of course, he paid the price later. And all the people in the Mahabharata, you take the example of Kunti, always worrying about her sons because they were victims of the evil schemes and controversies hatched by Shakuni, Dushasan, Duryodhana and Karna, these four, yes, but they did not think that, oh, Lord Krishna is there, that means everything will be fine. No, they never said like this. There is no reference, there is no quote, there is no instance in the Mahabharata where Arjuna or Yudhishthir or Draupadi goes and asks to Krishna, oh Krishna, they say you are God, but when you are there, how is this happening to us? No, this should not happen to us. You are God means everything should be perfect, right? There is no instance in the Mahabharata where the Pandavas speak to Lord Krishna like this. And there is no instance anywhere in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Yes, so many hundreds and thousands of verses in the Srimad Bhagavatam, but there is no reference of any pure devotee, any Paramahamsa, Shuddha Bhakta, he's going and asking to God, oh God, I'm there, I thought you were there with me, then how come I'm facing all these problems, okay? So, no great personality, yes, as Lord Krishna says in the Gita, that Mahatmanastu mam partha daivim prakritim ashritam bhajanti ananya manaso gyatva bhutadim avyayam. Mahatmanastu mam partha, oh partha, Arjuna, Mahatma is one. Who is Mahatma? Daivim prakritim ashritam. Who takes shelter of my divine potency. Yes. Bhajanti ananya manaso. With all his heart and soul, he chants my glories. Gyatva bhutadim avyayam. Knowing me to be the end of it all and the cause of all causes. So this means that God may sometimes fulfill our material ambitions or sometimes he may not fulfill. But having faith in God simply means that we have this faith that whatever is happening to us at this moment is the best thing that can happen to me. Should I repeat? Having faith in God simply means whatever is happening to us during this time, whatever is happening to me is the best thing that can happen to me. There's nothing better than this which can happen to us that is happening to me now. Yes. So as they say, man proposes, God disposes. So now this does not mean that we should not plan. This does not mean that we should not have a goal or ambition in life. We should have a goal. As they say, if you fail to plan, then you are planning to fail. So we should have our plans, we should have our goals, our ambitions, desires. We should have them. And then we should execute them. Yes, in whichever way it is good for that domain to be executed. But if that is not going the way we wanted, if it is getting reversed, if it is bouncing back, if we are needing to change it again and again due to whatever reason, then it should not happen that we go and curse God. We say that, oh, you don't exist. Yes, because from our perspective, things may be very great, but from God's perspective, it may be very foolish, something very stupid what we are doing. Yes, so many people I know, they come and tell me that, yes, I'm a believer in God. Why? Because, oh, God has fulfilled these things which I've asked. But then these same people will also have a long list of the things which God did not fulfill. And the day that list crosses this list, they become atheists. They may not become atheists necessarily, but their faith in God goes down. Yes, because today you might have something bodily, you may be very beautiful physically, yes. But tomorrow your health may spoil, or somebody may throw acid in your face. Then what? Then you will say, oh, God doesn't exist, these are all lies. No, that is not the correct approach. The best approach is that we always say, whatever God has given me, that is best for me according to my karma, and He knows best for me. Yes, because Lord Krishna says in the Gita, Suridam sarva bhutanam gyatva mam shantim ruchati. I am the most well-wishing friend of all living entities. Suridam sarva bhutanam, of all living entities. Yes. Gyatva mam shantim ruchati. And one who understands this obtains peace. Yes. Bhuktaram yagya tapasam sarva loka maheshwaram. That sloka is there. It's very famous in the Gita. So, the point of this video is, let us not make the results of our endeavors as a barometer for our connection to God, because tomorrow He may take it away, or He may not fulfill what we want. Today He has, or tomorrow He may not. Yes. So as I said, again I will say for the last time, the best part about God is He never listens to us. He will only listen to Himself, and He knows best what is good for us and what is bad for us, especially if you are embarking on a spiritual journey. Yes. This is not true for the general materialistic people. For them, whatever is there in the karma, that will anyways happen. Either they go here or they go there, they do this or they do that, nothing changes. But for anybody who is trying to go close towards God, yes, which means, as the Srimad Bhagavatam says, that we are not going to God and asking for materialistic benedictions. Now, that's not wrong to do. We can still ask, but we have to understand that sometimes He may not fulfill it, because He may think, he knows that this will not be good for us. If He sees that you are trying to go close to God and then to Him, and then there is some friend who is dragging you, pulling you down into bad things like alcohol, pornography, or doing too much unnecessary gossip and all those things, just talking about the opposite sex, all those things, then God is going to strip you away from that person, because God knows that that person's company is not going to bring auspiciousness into your life. And when that happens, we should thankfully say to God, thank you very much. Yes, so whatever God is doing to a person who is embarking on a spiritual journey, that is for His ultimate good, and at the end the results are beautiful. And at the end of the war of Kurukshetra, the Pandavas were victorious. Whatever happened, they suffered casualties, but the end result was they were victorious, even when they had only 7 Akshohinis, I guess, and the Kurus had 11 Akshohinis. Yes, we all know that. And then, of course, Lord Krishna was there on their sides. Alright, so that is it from my side, definition of faith. So, after a long time, new video. Alright, so I guess I could convey the meaning of what does it mean to have faith in God. Faith in God simply means that whatever is happening to me is the best thing that can happen to me. Always, now, every time, in future and in the past also, whatever had happened was for my ultimate good. Yes. So when we have that as the definition of our faith and our linkage to God, then never ever ever in our life will a time come when we are depressed about our spiritual progress. Yes. Because even if somebody who we love dies, even if somebody who we love leaves us, as people say, oh, that girl left me, she ditched me, she is going on with somebody else. Yes. Oh, that boy, he enjoyed me and then he left. All those things which people say. Then you will understand that, okay, whatever happened was for my good. I had to learn some lessons. And then now that person has departed after teaching me the lessons. And that person has showed me who not to behave like. Yes, that's very important. Sometimes wrong people come into our lives to teach us who we should not be like. Yes. So that is what I wanted to say. So do not make your material blessings as a barometer for your spiritual life or your connection to God. All right. So that is it from my side. If you're new to the channel and you have not yet subscribed, then please subscribe to it. And if you want a consultation, then please approach me through my website. The link is there in the description below. The sun is shining beautifully here. And tomorrow I will be going to Hamburg for celebrations of Narsingh Chaturdashi. All right. Until next time, wish you good luck with your faith. Okay. Bye-bye. See you.